Welcome back. I'm here with La Liga correspondent Matt Lord to talk about Barcelona versus Atletico Madrid. Big match, Matt. We'll start with the home side. Barcelona, they lost to Real Sociedad last time out. Really disappointing defeat for them.
It was very disappointing. I mean, it conceded early on to the Jordi Alba own goal. I mean, it was a great ball in from Sergio Canales, who was very good in that game. But to go 1-0 down early on, I mean, after the winter break is obviously disappointing. But you always expect Barcelona to come back and create chances. It never really transpired. They had sort of little bits and pieces during the game. The goalkeeper had some good saves late on, especially from Suarez. He made a really good save, but it was sort of disappointing overall the way they didn't. Their football was just a bit all over the place at the minute. Not really sure what formation they're playing. You know, is they playing short and snappy? Are they moving the phase? Are they trying to do it quicker? Are they getting back from front quicker? Are they playing long ball? It's a really big thing at the minute. They're not really sure what they're doing. And to lose 1-0 Sociedad after obviously Barcelona lost, they'd have gone top. So to lose that game, especially at Sociedad, who have not been great this season, it's really disappointing.
Obviously, the biggest headline from the match, even bigger than the scoreline, was the fact Messi started the game on the bench. That was such an interesting decision, a strange one from Luis Enrique, because you can maybe understand resting a few key players out during a big run of fixtures, a lot of fixtures coming thick and fast, but this had just come after the winter break, it's their first game back, so it's very strange this season. Messi, Neymar, Alves, Rakitic, Pique, all on the bench. It was almost the second string side for Barcelona, which, you know, in a match they could have gone top if they won, as you said. Yeah. That's a very strange decision. And then after you got Zubizarreta being sacked and Puyol resigning, there's talk about Messi perhaps leaving the club, which is strange, and a fallout with Enrique. It's a bit of a crisis going on at Barcelona at the moment.
I think the Sociedad team selection was a bit sort of disrespectful to Sociedad. I mean, Manuel Haddadi came into the team. He's been good this season, but not quite ready at the minute. Suarez played through the middle. Pedro played. Pedro's struggled. He's sort of gone in phases, but he's struggled lately. And like you say, to leave Messi on the bench. I mean, he brought him on at half-time. If you're going to do that, then you might as well just start him. Like, they brought Neymar in the second half, and I think there's an interesting thing that came out. I think it's a bit of a joke, but Neymar Suarez had a pushing match at training, and Messi was on fair with Enrique, who was reffing a five-a-side game in training. He gave a decision against Messi, and apparently that upset him. And it's just a little bit, you know, it's a little bit silly, little things like that. But it's all been going to Chelsea. I think Messi followed a couple of players on Instagram, didn't he? Courtois and Luis and stuff. I mean, that's to get Chelsea from that is a bit, you know, far-fetched to say the least. But it's certainly little bits. I mean, Zubizarreta leaving as well. I think the transfer thing's a big thing as well. Obviously, that got turned down. They've got their appeal, so they can't sign anyone until 2016. And I think if they can't sign anyone until that thing, they're not going to really let Messi go, because who are they going to replace him with? I mean, Suarez has only got one league goal to his name this season. They've scored twice overall, so he's still finding his feet. Neymar is their top scorer in the league. He's done really well, but overall, it's sort of a strange one, and there's, like I say, a bit of a crisis at the minute.
And Atletico will certainly be happy to see that happening. They're chasing and retaining the title, and it was a big weekend for them last weekend, wasn't it? Obviously, they won, and then both Real Madrid and Barcelona lost, so that moved them to within 1 point of the title now. And you know, you always saw it as being a bit of a two-horse race. It was hard to see Atletico matching their achievements of last season, but now they're level on points with Barca, 1 point away from Real Madrid. It's looking perhaps likely again that they might be able to push to retain the title, and that's a huge result. And obviously, going back to the Camp Nou, where they won the title last season, great memories of that. And they'll hope to get, if another good result here, and they'll really fancy their chances of pushing on, I think.
Yeah, last season, like you said, that was probably the scene of their greatest triumph. I mean, Sanchez scored early on for Barcelona, and if Barcelona won, they'd have won the league. But Diego Godin came back. I mean, I think he scored just after half time of a header, and it was so sort of typical of his season. And then they held on. Barcelona a lot of chances late on, but I think this game for Atletico will be interesting. It'll be Fernando Torres' league debut, possibly for the club. But you should see what happens with Miranda, because him and Godin last season, they formed a very good sort of defensive partnership, especially in the Champions League. And if they said him, there's talk of him going to Manchester City. I think Chelsea are interested as well. And I think there's a 19.5 million buyout clause in his contract. So, Jimenez has come in. He's plays sort of at international level with Godin. So, if he comes into the team, it'll be interesting. Miranda's obviously a very good player, but Atletico, they've beaten Real Madrid away this season, but they lost at Valencia. So the big games, like I said, it's sort of the same in the Premier League. The big games are important this season, probably more than any other. So it'll be interesting to see team selection. It'll be interesting to see how they set up against Barcelona.
This one could have a huge say on the title race. Which way do you see it going?
I mean, it's so tight, isn't it? I mean, earlier on the season, we did the Barcelona-Real Madrid preview, didn't we? And we said it's going to be really tight, and Real Madrid obviously came out on top that game. But again, I can see a draw. It's one of those games where you can sort of see Atletico conceding first, but they always fight back and then they sort of shut down. So a 1-1 draw is probably a safe bet. If you're going to put a bet on, I'd be betting 1-1 all day, and I think it will be a 1-1 draw. Yeah.
Sportsman going for a 1-1 draw.